This is for anyone who likes to use this guy. A hammer, a baseball bat, gorilla arms, etc. Honestly, if you are making a character with high body attribute points, I recommend trying out blunt weapons. Anyways, it's honestly pretty satisfying. What's going on, guys? It's Fish Fosh, and today I'm showcasing a build that is completely opposite of my usual hacker build. Today we go full-blown street brawler. And the reason why I'm doing this is I've played maybe about 150 plus hours on my main character, which was a Netrunner hacker build. Don't get me wrong, it was a lot of fun playing stealth. It was a lot of challenging, cool, fun ways to take on enemies. But at the same time, eventually, I mean, you play about 150 hours, you'll get bored of that playstyle. So I decided to make a completely new character dedicated solely for athletics, street brawler. And the one category I loved and enjoyed the most is blunt weapons. Yes, katanas, swords, and all that stuff is really also quite interesting, but I found using the hammer was something I actually just fell in love with. When I first tried it, the noise it just makes when you clunk onto an enemy's head is just really, really satisfying. So I would suggest this for anyone who wants to try something completely new, or if they're about to start off a new character, or if you're just completely new to the game, try out this build because it is something that is really, really fun. I would also like to say thanks to my current and new subscribers. I know I'm only at 58 subs, but it is really cool seeing the changes, even if it's just one sub here and there. And again, thank you. If you are new to the channel, of course, consider subscribing for more. Now, on to the build. This build is pretty straightforward, but I would be doing you guys wrong if I did not talk about cyberware recommendations. With that in mind, the only cyberware I would recommend is Second Heart, and any Berserk OS that you can find. It doesn't really matter which level, it's just really good to kind of get a head start, especially when you're about to start that fight. So Second Heart in general is just a really good way for you to keep on fighting, even though sometimes you're not paying attention too much to your health and you're just enjoying the actual fight. So this is a way for you to be reminded that yes, your character will die. So it is a nice little safety net that you have for your character to keep on killing. Now, when I say Berserk, and it doesn't matter which one, of course, the higher the level, the better. In my instance, I am using a Zetatech Berserk Mark IV. I have not done enough research to be like, yes, this is the one, this is the go-to. For now, I'm just gonna say use any legendary level Berserk. If you know of one specifically that is good for blunt weapons, leave it down in the comments below, because I'm gonna start focusing a little bit more on those kind of cyberwares, as I've already done so many of the hacking stuff. But for now, again, I'm using the Zetatech Berserk Mark IV. Okay, now for the perks. My character, as you guys can see, has a maxed out body attribute. Of course, depending on how far along you guys may be into the game, you may or may not have enough points to level this up. Like I said, I created this character with the sole thought that this is going to be a brawler, sword, katana, blunt weapon character, and I'm using it now for exactly that. So depending on what you guys have, if you want to start a brand new character, if you want to just try and alter what you can and try and get as many of these perks as possible, be my guest, do your thing. But this is just a build that highlights the full advantage of someone who is maxed out body street brawler with blunt weapons. So let's get started with athletics. First up, I would recommend is regeneration. This is a must no matter what build you make. You can acquire this at level 3. This perk allows you to heal slowly during combat. So if you find yourself overwhelmed, duck behind some cover and wait for the perk to activate. I find that this perk becomes a little bit more useless as we reach higher levels, because of course we have so many boosts to our HP later on in the game, but it just works really well, especially with a perk called Wolverine. This perk can be unlocked at level 16, and it triggers regen 90% faster when it is fully upgraded. The synergy between these two is perfect, and it works really well for the build. So instead of you constantly using up your consumables to heal yourself, you actually have these two that work really well. So you just really just sit there behind cover, wait for your health to regen just a little bit, and continue on fighting. That way, again, you don't use up any consumables, hopefully saving you some money or some of your valuable assets. It's totally up to you, but these two I think just work really well together. Next one is also a must no matter what build you are making, and that is invincible. This perk can be purchased at level 5. When it is fully maxed out, it increases your max HP by 30%. If you use this build like how I do, and that is just run around and duck for cover once in a while, this helps you become a bullet sponge. So my character right now is around 600 plus HP, of course, with the clothing that I do have on, but increasing your HP by 30% max is really a good way for you to become that bullet sponge. Speaking of becoming a tanky little bullet sponge, Indestructible decreases all incoming damage by 10%. Yeah, it doesn't sound like much, but with a combination of all the other perks, this is a must for the build, and this can be acquired at level 20. Along with that, having Steel Shell increases armor by 10% and can be acquired at level 18. Like I said, these numbers do not scream like absolute damage or absolute debuff, but when they are all combined, you literally become a tank. So having both Indestructible and Steel Shell is a combination of decreasing enemies' attack and increasing your own armor. So it just kind of is a cool little way, and I feel like the synergy with all these perks work that way, where you have a debuff for the enemy and a buff for yourself, which just makes that debuff and buff twice as potent. Now for Street Brawler perks. First up is Crushing Blows. I like to use the hammer, and with the hammer, I only use strong attacks because of how fun it is to just headshot and watch their heads explode. Crushing Blows takes full advantage of strong attacks. When it is fully upgraded, damage by strong attack is increased by 50%. And this perk can be unlocked at level 3, so this is why I say it's a must. Along with this perk, having Thrash, which can be unlocked at level 15, reduces enemies' armor by 30% for 10 seconds. So like I said, a lot of these perks kind of work hand in hand, where you get a buff and the enemy gets a debuff. Here you get a damage increase at the same time decreasing your enemy's armor by 30%, which is like, I don't know exactly the way the math works. I know it's not just like you all of a sudden have 100% damage increase on the enemy, but the fact remains that you increase your damage while the enemy reduces their own defenses, which just makes your attack much more stronger. The next three works really well together because it takes advantage of a debuff called Stun. The first one you're going to need is called Daze. This can be purchased at level 4. With the perk fully maxed out, you gain a 30% chance of dealing stun with any blunt attack. So it could be a heavy attack or a light attack. This allows for opportune strike to come in. With the enemies that are stunned, you gain a 50% damage increase. This perk can be acquired at level 8. And the last perk that takes advantage of a stunned enemy is Unshakable. This perk can be purchased at level 18, and this is a way to help you recover some HP and stamina while you are dishing damage. Successful attacks on enemies that are stunned restore 15% of your health and stamina when it is fully upgraded. So you guys get what I mean by the synergy of all these perks working hand in hand. So you have a perk that deals stun. One that takes advantage of that is you increase your damage to an enemy that is stunned. And another way for you to heal and recover stamina is if you hit that same stunned enemy, you actually heal and get more stamina back. So the way these perks work is they kind of build on top of each other. That way you can take advantage, full advantage of the perks that are in play. Lastly, for Street Brawler, we have Frenzy. This guy can be purchased at level 15. Defeating an enemy increases blunt weapon damage by 100% for 10 seconds. So if you don't have a legendary or an epic version Berserk operating system, this perk is one way for you to kind of bypass that. And of course, once you get yourself a higher level operating system, this just stacks right on top of it, making you even much more deadly. All right, so some may be wondering, what about stamina boosts? I skipped out a bunch of those because depending on how good you are with blunt weapons, you may not even need those perks. The one that I would suggest is Efficient Blows. When fully upgraded, it reduces stamina cost of all blunt weapon attacks by 50%. So that's one way for you to preserve your stamina, is using this perk. It just uses up less stamina overall, which means you can go on swinging without getting that debuff of running out of stamina. And yeah, that is it for me with this build. Like I said, I enjoyed this a lot because it seemed my playstyle in the beginning was much more stealthy, hacker oriented. So jumping to something completely opposite made every encounter, made every fight just completely different, new and unique. So let me know if this helped you guys out, or if you have any questions, of course, leave it in the comment section below and I will do my best to answer these questions. Please leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Next up, I'm going to be covering more Cyberpunk 2077 lore, so stay tuned for that. See you guys in the next vid. Bye.